A dream, once in the back of the mind, when sculpted as a vision, metamorphosed into a reality. Dr. Shankar Rao Chavan, Government Medical College, Nanded. In 1988, the then Chief Minister of Maharashtra, Dr. Shankar Rao Chavan, designated a committee under the leadership of Mr. Balasaheb Jadhav to explore the possibilities of having a government medical college at Nanded. The committee arrived at a conclusion that the plan was promising, and Nanded got its first medical college the same year.
3rd February 1988, government had appointed Professor Anatomy from Government Medical College, Aurangabad, that is Dr. Sayyed Fakhruddin, as officer on special duty. And the inauguration of the college took place in the presence of Mr. S.B. Sapan and the OSD of our college, that is Dr. Sayyed Fakhruddin.
The start of the college was just a small step on a road full of difficulties. One of the many challenges faced by the governing authorities was recognition by Medical Council of India.
The college was started, it was decided that this hospital, that is the then civil hospital, Guru Gobind Singh Ji Hospital, will be handed over to college, and therefore that will become easy for the NCI recognition to take. But although the decision was taken, I don't know what was the reason, but the public health department was not handing over this civil hospital to the medical education department.
The period between 1988 and 1989 was marked by struggle for recognition by Medical Council of India. It witnessed several protests in which the then faculty and local media played a crucial role.
After passing first MBBS, usual clinical teaching starts, ward clinic has to be started. But still the problem came. No clinical teachers has been appointed at Nanded. I remember only Dr. Zamdade sir was appointed as a lecturer in the surgery department. Still the hospital was not attached to the college. Then there is a problem of bedside teaching. Dr. Kalwale sir was a civil surgeon at that time, and there was a meeting between then Dean Dr. Fakhruddin sir and Dr. Kalwale, civil surgeon, and then they have made arrangement that this bedside clinical teaching has been given permission by the civil hospital to the medical college.
Post recognition from the Medical Council of India, the setting up of a larger infrastructure was at the top of the list, since the then campus was not able to live up to the standards of the Medical Council of India.
Then the political and administrative things has got fastened, and Professor Chalpati Rao from Hyderabad has been appointed as inspector for the inspection of the college. And the efforts at that time by Shirole sir and his team took, I still remember, he inspected the college, and within a 1 week he submitted his report to the Medical Council of India, and after that the day came that Nanded Medical College has been recognized by Medical Council of India, and there is a jaloush at Medical College Nanded, because the struggle since 1988 to 1993 has come to an end, and we got officially recognized by Medical Council of India.
I am from the 89 batch of this college. I had taken admission in the 89 and I passed in 94. That time college was a very small college. Even when we took admission that time, we were very apprehensive whether this college will serve whatever we were expecting from the medical education. But still when we got in the college, the campus was too small. It was just adjacent to the civil hospital. And there was no teaching or there were no classrooms as such. There were no college. It was all hospital only. But gradually in some months time, we realized that all that college part or the education part or graduation part is all about the teaching part. It's not related to as such the campus part. So the teaching was ultimate. The teaching was ultimate. All the teachers were very enthusiastic. Recently we had an alumni function. That time we had retrospectively we have analyzed all the students' data. That time we came to know that every batch has got almost 5 or 6 super study people. There are almost 50 people, 50 odd doctors who have passed from this college only. They had a graduation from this college and now they work in the same city. So alumni are always there and till the time college has got their own super study departments, we are always there to help.
Vishnupuri looked like a promising destination to hold the new campus. It was already home to an engineering college and a well-established university. So a state-of-the-art medical college was the only thing lacking in this growing educational hub.
Dr. Shankaraji Chauhan was the central cabinet minister. Due to some technical problems, we were not getting space there. But the people of this Nanded localites, they were not willing to shift the hospital from the minister's place because of the transport facilities, it becomes very difficult for the patient to go. In 2010, by Honorable Ashok Raji Chauhan, who was the chief minister of the government of Maharashtra, he said, we must shift and we have taken the decision of construction of the hospital building and college building in the 110 acres of the land.
For constructing the buildings, we saw that the building should be unique, should not have a typical planning of other hospitals, government hospital in the state. So the architect competition was conducted. Few architects participated in the competition and the eligible architect was selected.
The authorities appointed two able architects to shape the new campus. Architect Mrs. Sangeeta Joshi and Mr. Sushil Deshmukh shouldered this Herculean task.
We constructed the whole hospital complex in different buildings and those buildings are attached to each other by the center corridor. We have got a very beautiful OPD. We have got a operation theater complex which has got around 14 operation theaters, they are two modular type. We have got an ICU complex, we have got a patient care beds, that is the different wards. And the hospital administration building. We have got a very beautiful casualty. See, our casualty, I claim that there is nothing like our casualty in the whole state. We have got a surgical casualties, medical casualty, operation theater complex, and a disaster ward. We have got a resident hostel just above the casualty so that if any crisis situation, the doctors are available for the patient care. The total area of the hospital complex building is very huge. It exceeds what the MCI expect. We have made the provision of 150 bedded hospital medical student requirement. We have got a library building. We have got a gents and ladies hostel complex and a beautiful premises for the residential staff. So in this way, this 112 acre has been utilized in a very positive way.
Once the infrastructure was ready, the next challenge that stood before the authorities was the shifting of a fully functional civil hospital to the new facility.
In 2015, hospital was almost completed. Then the time of the shifting had been started. And once we inspected this medical college, hospital for shifting purpose, we have found some small deficiencies, small problems were there. We have done a persuasion with the PW department and some defects we are trying to rectify and correct. For this shifting procedure, myself is a soulmate of Nanded and Dr. Maisekar is of Bhumipatra of Nanded. We were having a very long relation of 27 years and under his able guidance, started shifting the patient.
Shifting an operational civil hospital filled with patients was never going to be an easy task, especially when there is a shortage of manpower, including doctors and class 4 servants. There were about 700 patients at that time, of which 200 were serious. Dr. Jamdade sir sheds light on the circumstances at that time.
The day of shifting, that was 11th of the October, we have planned to shift the patient in a one day only. In the morning, 8 o'clock, we have started to shift non-troublesome patients or the patient who can ambulatory or mobilize. Once ambulatory patient shifting was over, then we have concentrated on the B group of the patient, those who require the care, but patient may not be in a very serious status. That patient was shifted, and at the last we have shifted the patient, those who are very critically ill or very difficult to shift. That patient was shifted. Like this way, we have shifted all this patient within the period of 12 hours of the time. Whenever any institute, if you want to take it to the high and high level, this cannot be done by one or two person. There we need support of all. I request all my doctors, my students, all workers of this medical college and the beneficiaries and public of Nanded to give your hands to improve this medical college.